Good morning to everybody. I am Professor Steephan, Department of English, GCE Bargur. Now I am going to teach you what are the mistakes we commit in English. In our day-to-day speech, when we communicate, when we introduce ourselves to others, we commit small mistakes, but we have to correct them. That I am going to teach you. How do you introduce yourself? Most often, we introduce, just say, I'm Stephen. Some of us may say, my name is Stephen. Some people say, myself Stephen. Just to look into these three sentences. I am Stephen. My name is Stephen, and myself Stephen. The first two sentences are correct. The last one, if you say, myself is Stephen, that's wrong. It's a great blunder that you commit. You have to avoid. We are all educated people. We are all well-versed in our subject. But when we say this particular sentence, it will not speak well of you. So, if you want to introduce yourself, you just say, I am Stephen, or my name is Stephen. But don't say at any cost, myself is Stephen. There is no such phrase in English. If you want to say better way, then I tell you certain phrases. I would like to introduce myself as Stephen. I would like to introduce myself as Stephen. I have a great privilege of introducing myself as Stephen. Or, it's my great pleasure to introduce myself as Stephen. When you go for a seminar, when you present paper, when you come together as a gathering like this, you have to introduce yourself. Then you just say, these are the more formal phrases instead of saying, I am or my name is. Because my name is something like this, no? Even LKG, UKG students are saying that. What's your name if you ask? My name is Kumar. Or in a formal way itself, actually some people say I am. That's also good, that's also great. But if you say more formal, if you want to say more formal, I would like to introduce. You see? I'm sorry. I would like to introduce myself as Stephen. But we have to be very careful here. You see this one. I would like to introduce myself as Stephen. If you elongate the sound, it means as. You know what does mean by as? I would like to introduce myself as. Don't say as. If it means fool, stupid, and then donkey. So we have to be very careful. Pronouncing this particular word, we have to be very careful. How to pronounce this word is very important. And another sentence I told you, I have a great privilege of introducing myself as Stephen. It's my great pleasure to introduce myself as you. Okay? Then, let's go for another word. Pursue. All of us know this word, pursue. You say, I am pursuing PhD. Is it correct? Even we people say, we educated people say, we are pursuing PhD. In the meaning of, actually you say, studying. No. Pursue means chase. Go after. Running after. Are you really going after PhD? Are you chasing PhD? No. We are studying PhD. We are doing research. But we say simply, I am pursuing PhD. It means you are going after PhD. You are chasing PhD. So that should be avoided. And another word,
pronounce these words,
we all of us pronounce as resume. There are two pronunciations. One is resuming and another one is resume. Actually, in the meaning of biodata, you have to put slanting bar just above R and E. This is resuming. This one is noun. Where is your resume? You have to ask like this. Don't ask where is your resume. Resume means, suppose you are going to Chennai, you stop in the middle, you take rest for refreshment, and then you continue your journey. Am I correct? You take for refreshment, for a few hours, and then you continue your journey. Then you have to say, I resume my journey. Stop a little bit, in the middle of the journey, and then you continue. Suppose you do one work, you take rest, and then you continue. In that case, in that sense, you can say, I resume my work, I resume my journey, and so on. But don't say, in the meaning of biodata, the word resume, it's wrong pronunciation. So you have to hereafter say, resume. And writing, biodata or curriculum Y shape, you just put, slanting bar just above these two letters. Okay? And often, actually, all of us pronounce this word often. Nothing wrong in this pronunciation. If you pronounce as often, is it correct? That's also correct. There are two accents. One is American and another one is British. But in Britain itself, there are many more accents. There are two major universities. One is Oxford and another one is Cambridge. Oxford University students pronounce this word as often. Cambridge University students pronounce this word as often. But both are acceptable. But in the Indian context, we all of us pronounce this word as often. That's correct. But we have to know the slight difference also. Even this word can be pronounced in such a way. Because in Britain, the two major universities follow two different pronunciation. One is often, another one is often. Okay. But if you pronounce this word often, you just clarify. This is also right. This is not wrong. Because in this word, there are two pronunciations found. Okay? Thank you, my dear students and friends. Let's meet once again with many more words like this. Thank you.